Good morning, one and all. So, dear students, last class we can read discuss about the some importance of the carbon and its compounds. So, next we can discuss about the soap and detergent. So, how should be the soap and detergent should be prepared? What are the soaps? Chemically, you can be called as the soap. A soap is the one of the sodium salt or potassium salt of the long chain of the carboxylic acid, which is clean property in water. So that is can be called as the soap. Soap means it is a sodium or potassium salt of the long chain of the carboxylic acid, which has cleaning property in the water. That is can be called as the soap. So soap we can be prepared by the not only from the vegetable oil, we can be also prepared from the animal fat also. It is made from animal fat or vegetable oils. They are naturally occurring in the esters in highly fatty acid and alcohol is called glycerol. So you already know that esterification reaction. Esterification means they are to the fruity smell. So that is you can regard as the esters. They are naturally occurring esters, highly fatty acid and then alcohol called glycerol. So what is the main product you can be obtained from that one alcohol? That is you can regard as the glycerol. So first, what happened here? First, you can be taken on the one tank. So oil or fat, then you can be added into the sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide. That one, we can be introduced in the iron tank. So when oil or fats are heated with the sodium hydroxide solution, they will split up into sodium salt of the higher fatty acid and glycerol. So when fat and oil is treated into the sodium hydroxide, they can be given as to sodium salt of the fatty acid and glycerol. The molecules of the soap are sodium or potassium salt of the long chain of the carboxylic acid. So what is the meaning of soap means? It is the long chain of the fatty acid of the sodium or potassium salt of the long chain of the carboxylic acid. So see here, the soap molecule should be consist of the NaCl plus, you can be write down. So they are consist of the two bonds, one is ionic end, another is the non-ionic end, you can be seen. So the ionic end of the soap interact with water while carbon chain interact with oil. So whatever dust particles are there, they will be left on the cloth. So when we wash it that one, we have to, the ionic end of the soap interact with water and while whatever the carbon chain should be interact with the oil. Oil means they will be make a micelles forms. The soap molecule thus form the structure called micelles. So when we wash the any cloth, they have to, the dirt should be removed from the cloth. So that is can be called as the micelles. So look at the picture here. So here when we remove the cloth, so what happened? We have to show the. So we have to show the that one. How can be that these cleaning action should be occur? So next one is detergent. These are the generally sodium salt of the sulfonic acid or ammonium salt with a chloride or bromide ions. Then we can regard as the long chain of the hydrocarbon should be formed. That is, you can regard as the detergent. So detergents are generally, they are the sodium salt or salt of sulfonic acid or ammonium salt of the chloride or bromide. That is, you can regard as the detergents. Why it can be used for the detergent means they can be easily washed with the water and they can be given to the scum for the onions. You can be used for the these detergents. The charged end of the these compounds do not form the insoluble precipitate. So in case of the, if you wash the water with a soluble, then what happens, then they have to the not completely soluble. Here it should be the insoluble, not forming the insoluble precipitate with the calcium or magnesium ions in the hot water. So detergent you can use it for the hard water also. Yes, it is easily given to the scum for the, that one. Yes, you can use it for the this one. So detergents we can be used for the making of the shampoo and cloths also. So detergents are usually make shampoo and product for the cleaning cloths also. So related to that one, we have the one question here. Micelles are soap molecules in clean water. Drop of oil or dirt that surround the molecule, a tadpole shaped fatty acid, A cluster of soap molecules surrounding the dead particles. The correct answer is cluster of soap molecules surrounding the dead particles.
38. How is an ester formed? Reactions of ethanoic acid. Ester is formed when carboxylic acid is heated with alcohol in the presence of an acid catalyst. This process is called esterification reaction. For example, when ethanoic acid is heated with ethanol in the presence of acid catalyst, forms ethyl acetate. Esters are sweet smelling substances. Esters are used in making of perfumes and as flavoring agents. Esters on treatment with an alkali like sodium hydroxide converted into alcohol sodium salt of carboxylic acid. This reaction is called saponification reaction. Ethyl acetate on treatment with sodium hydroxide converted into ethanol and sodium acetate. Common smell of the ester is fruity. Let us perform an activity to identify the odor of an ester. Take 1 ml of ethanoic acid and 1 ml of glacial acetic acid in a test tube. Add a few drops of concentrated sulfuric acid. Warm the reaction mixture for at least 5 minutes in water bath. Pour reaction mixture into a beaker containing 20 to 50 ml of water and smell the resulting mixture. Smells like nail polish remover. Like several acids, ethanoic acid reacts with the base to give a salt and water. For example, when ethanoic acid reacts with sodium hydroxide, a base, it forms sodium ethanoate, or commonly called sodium acetate, and water. Sanitizers. In olden days, clothes were washed by rubbing or beating on the rocks. This practice is followed even today in many rural places. Sometimes, the fruits or seeds of plants like soap nut are used as cleaning agent. Let us discuss about modern chemical soaps and detergents. What is soap? Soaps are made of sodium or potassium salts of long-chain fatty acids. General formula of a soap can be written as RCOO. R is an allyl group that usually containing 12 to 18 carbon atoms. Detergent is non-soap cleansing agent. It is classified into natural detergent and synthetic detergent. Natural detergent is made from animal or vegetable oil, while synthetic detergent is extracted from petroleum. Commercially made detergents are usually sodium alkyl sulfate and sodium alkyl benzene sulfonate. Saponification is an organic chemical reaction that utilizes an alkali to clean an ester into a carboxylic acid and alcohol. Let us see how soap is prepared in a laboratory. Materials required: vegetable or coconut oil, sodium hydroxide solution, sodium chloride or common salt, glass rod, spirit lamp, beaker, mold tray. Procedure: take 25 ml of vegetable or coconut oil in a beaker. Place it on a boiling stand and pour 30 ml of sodium hydroxide solution. By using a spirit lamp, heat the mixture to a gentle boil. Stir constantly to avoid scattering or spilling of the mixture. Boil for 20 minutes until all the water gets evaporated. supplies remove the soap from the tray. Thus, the soap is a ethanol and ethanoic acids are the two important carbon compounds in our daily life. Let us discuss the properties of these two compounds. Ethanol. It is a colorless, inflammable and sweet smelling liquid. The common name of ethanol is ethyl alcohol. Ethanol is commonly known as alcohol and it is the main constituent of all alcoholic drinks. Ethanol is a good solvent. Ethanol can cause drunkenness on consumption even in small quantities of dilute ethanol. Extremely poisonous when consumed in pure form. It is soluble in water. Reactions of ethanol. It involves in different chemical reactions due to the presence of hydroxyl group. For example, when ethanol reacts with sodium, it gives sodium ethoxide and hydrogen gas.
Saturated and unsaturated compound. Carbon chain from the skeleton
may vary in length, having spring and branch, or arranged in the form of a ring. The common skeleton may also include single, double, and triple bone.
Gets